Well, friends and friendsozens, I am here today to remove the veil of mystery over the dark art of overclocking.
Overclocking, oh yeah, it is amazing.
But what is it? Well, simply said, we are going to juice out some extra and free performances out of your processor. And that's really, really, really cool. But before we get started, let me say this. Overclocking can be dangerous to your processor or other components in your machine. All the steps I'm describing here are the steps that work for me, and I cannot guarantee the results for you on your side. You need to know that you may very well fry your processor and harm any other components in your build. This is a risk that you are willing to take. Therefore, do what you do at your own risks. If you're still here and watching this, then let's just jump right in. Your processor runs on a clock or frequency. The higher it goes, the more performance you get out of it. So what do we need to get started? Three things: the right CPU, the right motherboard, and the right cooling system. Processors, they all overclock differently. Doesn't matter if they are the same brand or even the very same model. Once you acknowledge that there are some random elements in the production line of CPUs themselves, then you also acknowledge that after overclocking a processor, it's a bit of a lottery. Some of them may very well give you up to 50% in performance increase, and some others will just give you 5% performance increase. Now, do not worry. We can maximize our chances of success by selecting the right kind of processor. The K processor. Intel has released K processors for enthusiasts.
Me, 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 me.
And they are designed specifically to be overclocked. All the security features, who usually protect the CPU, have been removed or never put in the first place. So all the CPUs with a model name which finishes by K are the ones we want to buy, such as the i7-4790K or the i7-6700K. So what are the practical steps? Two variables we can play with to indeed increase the performance of your processes: the multiplier and the voltage. Multipliers refer to the number to which you multiply the CPU base clock, usually 100 MHz. So for example, if you have a 2 GHz processor, you probably have a multiplier equal to 20, because 20 times 100, 2 GHz. But a processor with a higher frequency needs more electricity, so we have to raise the voltage as well. Higher voltage means higher temperatures. So if you're not really, really careful and very gradual in the way you are bringing up the voltage on your CPU, you may actually burn it. But what would happen if you were to run an overclock processor without increasing the voltage? Well, it probably would become unstable, meaning that your system won't boot, and that as soon as you trigger a heavier application, it will give you a blue screen. If that happens to your system, the best way to address this issue is to decrease the multiplier or to slightly increase the voltage going to the CPU. And now let's review the motherboard. Just as we've seen it with CPUs, not all motherboards are equally useful for overclocking. The best ones are usually the gamers' motherboards. They're the ones who give you the most comprehensive collection of tools which will allow you to tweak and play around with your CPU frequency and voltage. On top of this, some really cool gamers' motherboards now give us the ability to monitor the live temperature of the CPU through a thermal digital screen soldered right in it. And now we get to the cooler systems. When you first unbox your CPU, you will find right away that there is some kind of CPU fan in there. Here, I'll show it to you. That thing. It looks good. Nah, actually it doesn't even look good. It's just absolutely useless, and we are never going to use this for an overclocking job. We are going to go for aftermarket CPU coolers. Aftermarket air coolers. They are quite inexpensive and they work pretty well for overclocking purposes. The only issue with it is that it makes a lot of noise, it's quite heavy and bulky, so it'll probably interfere with other elements on your motherboard, and in some cases will prevent you from closing your computer altogether, because it will stick out of the case. Water cooling systems. Sure, it is more expensive, and if you've never used them, the first reflex would be like, oh, is water able to go safely in a computer? And am I not gonna blow the whole thing out? Or no worries whatsoever. We have one loop water cooling system there. Completely factory sealed. It's very, very resistant and easy to install. Good thing about it is it's completely silent and nothing will cool your CPU as well as a water cooling system. But remember, whatever your choice is, you can only overclock a processor as much as you can cool it. One last note on this. The higher the voltage or the higher the temperature, the shorter is the lifespan of your CPU. In my case, since my CPU is powered at 1.4 volt, I probably decreased the lifespan of my processor by half. So I should be able to use it for 3 to 4 years. So please do keep this in mind when you do your overclocking. Now, if you have successfully followed every step in this video, that means you have overclocked your first processor! How does it feel? How does it feel? Well done, well done! Do you feel the change? You probably ask yourself if you look better, if you sound better, if you smell better. Yes, you do. Yes, you do. You do. And that's it for me today. Feel free to add any comments or questions you may have. I will take the time out of my very busy schedule to answer them. Dear YouTube subscribers, you know what to do. If you liked the video, like it. If you didn't like it, don't like it. But both ways, make sure to subscribe to my little channel, because that will give you eternal youth.